بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Today we will have case quiz number 45. Case data: 24 years old male evaluated in the emergency department for a 3-day history of right eye redness and pain photophobia with decreased visual acuity. He had 2 years history of recurrent painful oral ulcerations and tender nodules on his chins, as well as occasional knee and ankle pain for the last 3 months. His only medication is occasional ibuprofen for joint pain. On examination, temperature slightly increased 37.3, blood pressure within normal 114/78, pulse rate tachycardic 105 beat per minute, and respiratory rate within normal 18 per minute. Body mass index is 26. On ophthalmological examination, there is a ciliary flush around the right limbus and a constricted pupil. A slit lamp examination revealed findings consistent with anterior and posterior uveitis. Retinal vasculitis is also present. Oral ulcerations varying in size from 3 mm to 1 cm are noted on the inner cheek, palate, and tongue. The lungs are clear. The abdomen is non-tender. No bruit are noted. The left knee and right ankle are swollen. Peripheral pulses are normal. Investigations revealed. Chest radiograph revealed a prominent right pulmonary artery, and the CT of the chest demonstrate an aneurysm of the right pulmonary artery. So, what is the most likely diagnosis? Is it case Behçet disease, granulomatosis with polyangiitis, which was previously known as Wagner granulomatosis or Wagner disease, polyarthritis nodosa, or sarcoidosis? Take a while to think, and you can stop the video here. And the answer is yes, it is Behçet disease. The patient most likely has Behçet disease. Behçet disease is a rare systemic disorder characterized by vasculitis and involvement of multiple visceral organs. The most important diagnostic clue are intermittent mucous membrane alterations and ocular involvement. Gastrointestinal, pulmonary, musculoskeletal, and neurological manifestations also may be present. The patient has a 2-year history of recurrent oral ulcerations, erysema nodosum, and arthritis, and now present with panuveitis, retinal vasculitis, and a pulmonary artery aneurysm, manifestations that are strongly suggestive of Behçet disease. Other differential diagnoses included in this case are granulomatosis with polyangiitis. Patient with granulomatosis with polyangiitis, previously known as Wagner granulomatosis, can present with uveitis, retinal vasculitis, arthritis, and oral ulcers as seen in this patient. However, the vasculitis associated with granulomatosis with polyangiitis involves small rather than large blood vessels, and aneurysms are not seen at all. Patients with granulomatosis with polyangiitis often have a history of upper airway disease such as sinusitis or epistaxis, and often have glomerulonephritis, none of which is present in this patient. So this differential is excluded. Other differential diagnosis for this case included polyarthritis nodosa. Although polyarthritis nodosa can result in arterial aneurysm, it typically affects medium-sized mesenteric and renal arteries rather than pulmonary arteries, and commonly results in intestinal ischemia and renovascular hypertension. Oral ulcers, uveitis, and erythema nodosum typically don't occur. Other differential diagnoses for this case included sarcoidosis. Sarcoidosis can manifest as arthritis and uveitis, and rarely can be associated with large vessel vasculitis. Pulmonary artery aneurysm are not typical for sarcoidosis. Chest radiograph usually demonstrate hilar lymphadenopathy with or without parenchymal lung disease and sarcoidosis, so also this differential diagnosis was excluded. The key point here is Behcet disease is characterized by oral and genital ulcers, ocular disease, and involvement of the dermatological, articular, gastrointestinal, and nervous systems. And finally, thank you very much for your attendance, and we will see you tomorrow with case quiz number 46. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.